folks, Ed Stevens here. I'm away to another vinyl destination. Today, taking you to a record store called the Corner Record Shop. I have one of their shirts on, but thanks to the seatbelts, it's in the way. There you go. Corner Record Shop in Granville. And me and my brother-in-law discovered this by accident on our way back from, we were going to antique mall shopping stuff one day, and we passed this great store. He stopped in, he got what he wanted, and I got what I wanted. It was just a great place to be, and I never forgot. It's been 2 or 3 years since I discovered the place. And they have another outlet up in Big Rapids, Michigan, I believe. I haven't been to that one, but I'll be taking you there, and I'll be videoing there, and hopefully they don't get all ticked off at me. But I've seen videos of them on YouTube before, so they shouldn't. This will be in HD, too. There's where these camera phone type videos, you see, you know. Now I gotta see HD Corner Record Shop in Granville, Michigan on Vinyl Destinations.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Day here. 80 degrees. Finally getting up there. It's a good day to go vinyl hunting. Yay! Friggin' stoplights. Such a good time. Not. Come on, things take forever. I have to vinyl dig. The Corner Record Shop, here I is. Buy, sell records, CDs, and DVDs. One of my favorite hangouts away from my own town. Let's mosey around, see if I can get some cooperation by these sellers. Concerts and stuff posted up here. On the way in. Mm-hmm. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm pretty good. You don't mind if I make a video, do you?
Go ahead.
It's probably been done before. I've seen it on YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
So. Here it is, folks. See, this is where it's going to go on YouTube. great. Here's all the CDs. New vinyl. Blue thing. What my basement walls used to look like. All the tapes over there. There you go, the first LP. I have that on CD. One of my home taping delights from way back when. Bebop Deluxe. Thinking about this one. I have the CD, but I don't have the vinyl. So. My favorite bin. Have that one. Kind of groovy stuff on the wall. more groovy scenes. This is different. We never had all this equipment back here before. Radios. This looks like my house. It's all the 45. VHS tapes. Ceiling's covered too. Parachute. More groovy equipment sitting around. All the 8-tracks, huh? They moved these, they used to be more upright. Mule the readers. So you got a lot more 45s in. Put your 8-tracks above here.
Like, wait. Pump truck got fired, you made it.
Right.
You're looking for like late 80s, 90s kind of.
You fired at my mom, didn't you?
Where they sell new stereos. They're reconditioned or whatever.
That turntable there is carbon fiber.
Just nice and dark. Lightweight. V-Max
audio. It's gotta be olive oil. Yeah.
pull up the walls and, you know, we just put walls around it and closed it in and cut a hole in this wall to open it between the two. And,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, I remember that room there, but I don't think anything beyond. This is the first time I've seen this one, so I mean, I don't think I've been here maybe a year or so. It's making a video for YouTube.
That's funny.
Yep. Yeah. Project, they also, in the factory, make a lot of music hall turntables. Mm. So they make two different manufacturers, and they make them to their specs, you know. The problem with that, being an old VPI guy, is that never sure I was right. I would just rather have it set up in the middle and have it be there. Mm. Just sometimes there's just too many adjustments.
Okay, takes inventory now. What I bought at the corner record shop. Hope you enjoyed the tour there. Had a special listening room like you saw. I never seen that before, so that was a something new for me. I got the Bebop Deluxe album like I said I would. Like I said, I have the CD of it already, and now I got the vinyl for the vinyl zone. Outside, inside the tubes, this has the hit single She's a Beauty on it. That was from 1983, I believe. The tubes. Dave Mason, the very first album of his. I had two or three copies in there, and I finally, one had a bad cover, and one had, the disc had a big scratch in it, but then I found two other ones that were fairly decent, so I lucked out there. I just kept on looking and found two other ones. I got this on a reel-to-reel at home. Somebody else recorded it. I bought it at Goodwill, the tape that is, and I don't know who the heck. I recognized the title, You Can't Take It When You Go. Take It When You Go, okay, and so I recognized that. I got the Moody Blues, Every Good Boy Deserves a Favor, another CD I have at home. But I don't have the gatefold cover, just a dinky little booklet that has all this artwork in it. And it says, Story in Your Eyes on it. And that was my visit to the corner record shop, June 2013. I may come back again in a few more months, who knows. Off to another area that I like to go, Goodwill on Lake Michigan Drive. Personally, I wasn't all that impressed with that stereo I was listening to that in that listening room, but maybe I didn't crank it up loud enough, I don't know. There was no bass or anything, I guess it's there for looks mostly, I don't know. Anyway, I'd have to hear it my way instead of their way in order to really judge, you know what I mean? I'm off to a Goodwill, like I said, on Lake Michigan Drive. This is Chicago Drive here in Granville. Here we go. Elvis. School desk. Cool. Okay, here's a recap of what I picked up at Goodwill. This After the Gold Rush by Neil Young, one album I didn't have. And cover's not in the greatest condition, but the vinyl looks pretty good, so only a buck. And there's the gatefold of them inside there. Just resting, chilling out by listening to his music on records. And Tom D. Hall, Greatest Hits. Is that Volume 2? Yeah, Volume 2. And I bought it because of the song I Like Beer. And there's another song in there called I Love, which I'm... Wow, it's light in here. It's sunshine. I'll probably... Someday I gotta have a country show. I'm building up stuff. And another copy of Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player by Elton John. It was in good condition. The booklet inside's falling out, but so what? I got another copy of this. I thought, oh well, maybe I could use it for a trade. Again, if someone needs a Elton John album or something. I don't know. But I couldn't pass it up with, you know, the condition it was in for a buck. And I was surprised. I thought the corner record shop there was going to charge me $11 for the bunch, but he only charged me $9, so I think that's like $3 a record then. Because I paid $8 for that first one, that Bebop Deluxe, and then I thought I was going to pay $1 each for those three afterwards, but then he must have charged me $3 for $1, so I wound up paying $9 plus tax, something like that, for the whole bunch. So for $12, I got six albums for $12. Pretty good. Well, this is my vinyl destination program for June of 2003. And who knows when I'll go out again. And this is Ed Stevens talking to you. See you in the vinyl zone. Bye. We'll be right back.